When Affinity Studio refuses to start, it can feel like the whole creative flow just stops. You click the icon, wait for the splash screen, and then it disappears. No error message, no warning, nothing. It's like the app changed its mind at the last second. This problem has been happening to quite a few users lately, especially after recent updates. But the good news is it's not a big system failure or a major bug that needs a reinstall. The cause is actually something very small inside a hidden folder on your computer, and fixing it only takes a few minutes. So, let's go step by step and get Affinity Studio opening again. First, make sure hidden files are visible on your computer. Windows hides certain folders by default, and that's exactly where the broken file sits. To show them, open any File Explorer window. Click on View at the top menu and then check the box that says Hidden Items. That single step will make a few new folders appear that you couldn't see before. Now, open this PC and follow this path carefully. Open the Users folder, then the folder with your username. Inside there, you'll see a folder called App Data. Open that one, then go into Roaming. Inside Roaming, you'll see a folder called Affinity. And when you open that, you'll find another folder also named Affinity. That second one is the problem. What happens here is that the app stores its settings and user data inside those folders. After an update or a system crash, those saved settings can sometimes get corrupted. When Affinity tries to read them, the next time it starts, it gets confused and shuts down instantly. So the solution is simple. Delete that extra Affinity folder inside Roaming. That forces the app to create a brand new clean settings folder when it starts next time. Before deleting anything, make sure you're inside the right place. You might see folders for other software too, but don't touch them. Just delete the one named Affinity inside the Roaming and Affinity path. Once you've done that, close File Explorer and try launching Affinity Studio again. It should open up smoothly this time. No crash, no freeze, no black screen. You don't even need to restart your computer. The fix takes effect instantly. Now, it's worth knowing that this small issue happens because the software stores configuration data locally. That's what allows it to remember things like your last open document, custom brushes, and window layout. If any of those files get corrupted, maybe after a forced shutdown or a Windows update, the app simply refuses to start. Deleting that folder resets those settings to default. The only downside is that any custom workspace layouts or preference tweaks will need to be redone, but at least the program will finally open again and you can get back to work. To prevent this from happening again, it helps to keep your Affinity apps updated from the official website or the Microsoft Store. Also, try closing the app properly before shutting down your computer. Avoid using system cleaners that delete configuration data from the App Data folder, since they can sometimes remove essential files. Once everything's working, take a moment to reapply your favorite settings, import your brushes, and save your workspace. That way, even if it happens again, you will know exactly how to recover it quickly. So that's it. Just a small hidden folder standing between you and your next creative project. Now, Affinity Studio should start up without any crashes or surprises. Enjoy your editing and keep designing with confidence.